Okay, so this is the second part of the second tutorial on adding dynamics on NetLogo networks. We have seen in the previous video the homophily mechanism. We will now see the transitivity mechanism. So you already heard about this mechanism. We will do that for undirected networks. So the idea is that if you have three nodes A, B, and C, A is connected to B and B is connected to C, transitivity implies that A should be connected to C. It's like closing the triangle between AB and BC. The NetLogo behavior will have this form. So every node should say, if I have a neighbor N1 and if N1 has a neighbor N2 that is not me, I create a link with N2. To do that, we will have to store the identity of the nodes on your network. We will do that with the keyword who returns the ID of every turtle, and we will store it into a variable with the keyword let that is used to declare a variable. So the transitivity pseudo algorithm will be to ask one turtle with at least one neighbor to store the ID of the current turtle, so the asking turtle ID, asking the neighbors of the current turtle who have at least one neighbor that is not the current turtle, and you ask to the neighboring turtles if you have one neighbor whose ID is not the stored ID, so not the ID of the asking turtle of the beginning, create a link with the turtle ID. So this is what we will do, but in NetLogo. So we take back the code. So remember that we have something to create links and to make a layout between the nodes. We can add some homophily links. Okay, so now we will have to code the transitivity mechanism. So the first thing to do is to declare the function. So we'll say to add one transitive link. Okay, so we start by asking one node who have some neighbors. So we have to ask one of the turtle with, so at least one neighbor is just counting the link neighbors, and be sure that it is greater or equal to one. Okay, so we ask for one turtle to ask their we ask one turtle with at least one neighbor. So we store the ID of the turtle because we do not want to create the same link between the node and the neighbors. So we have to store the ID to be sure that the transitivity will be closing the triangle. So we store the ID of the turtle by declaring a variable that will be called myID. And we put the keyword who returns the ID of every turtle, in this variable. So we ask one of the turtles to store its ID. Then, it's like the case of homophily, we will ask one of the linked neighbors of the current turtle. Link neighbors of the current turtle. Who has neighbors? And that is not me. So we will first check that this turtle has some neighborhood. Oh, sorry. So we check that one of the neighbors of the current turtle also have some neighbors. So count link neighbors greater to 1. There I put a strict greater because we already know that he has a neighbor since it is one of the neighbor of the current total. So we want that he has more than one neighbor, because if he only have one neighbor, the neighbor is the current total, since we have asked the neighbor of the current total. So with strictly more than one neighbor, to do something, to do what? To ask one of his neighbor, so the first neighbor has to ask his other network, is an other neighbor than the asking turtle, to create a link with the asking turtle. So ask one of the link neighbors, and then here it's here that we want to check that this is not the asking turtle, so with a condition on the identity of the turtle. So with who is different than my idea. So this will check that the neighbor, so this is the first neighbor. The first neighbor will ask his neighbor which are not the calling turtle, the first current turtle, to create a link with, and then we say create a link with the first asking turtle. So we do that by specifying the ID of the turtle. So turtle is a keyword, and when you add an ID, a value of a variable that you have declared to be equal to who, it tells to NetLogo to say this turtle with this ID. So here we will create a link with the turtle who has the ID equal to my ID. And then at the creation, we'll say, okay, set the color to be, let's say pink. Okay. This should do the job. We'll test the code. Let's go back to interface. Add a button to call the written function. Add one transitive link. We try. Okay, seems to work. Okay, we should check that it works on very simple network, like this kind of network. Okay, so for example, one transitive link should be more visible on this kind of configuration. So a transitive link could be added here, for example, or here, or here, or here, and so on. Let's check. Okay, this is good, this is also good, this is also good, and so on, and so on. It seems to work. We may have the same problem than with the homophily function. That is, that sometimes node will have no neighbors, so the function will crash because of not finding neighbors when you ask one of the link neighbors with an account, etc. So to check that we ask to the proper node, we should take here, make here a check. So this code should be checked before we execute it, that there is effectively some nodes with the sufficient number of neighbors and so on. So here I should add if there is any turtles with count neighbor superior to one, greater than one, then I execute all this code. Okay, this is to check that there is some neighbors with the sufficient number of neighbors to for the function to terminate properly. Okay, so that that should be it. We have had two dynamic process on our network, that is the homophily process, so we add one homophily link when it's possible, and the transitivity process that will close the triangles of our network. So this is basically what we could do with that. Well, it seems that my netlogo instance is a little bit stuck. It happens sometimes. When it happens, you can either wait to for the netlogo program to be closed by hand with your mouse, or like that, or you can just kill the process with the depending on your operating system, with the monitor of activity in macOS or in the just task manager on Windows. Okay, so this is it for the second tutorial of dynamic process adding on the netlogo network that we have built in the first tutorial. Thank you.